Hello and welcome to the new episode of GeoProspectors webinar sessions. I'm Tibor, the data analyst by GeoProspectors. In the upcoming couple of minutes, I'm going to introduce to you how our variable depth tillage application works, as well as online and in offline environments, which data is acquired during survey, then used for control in different applications. First things first, I'm going to describe in the overview section which ideas, directions we took into account in defining tillage strategies. We are going to have a closer, detailed look on the individual tillage modes, which are selectable in online and map-based control as well. As an overview of cultivation modes, we can distinguish four different modes of operation, which we can furthermore classify for two main focuses, let's say purposes in mind. The first class is general soil conditioning. This class was designed for preserving resources during application. Shallow cultivation and subsoiling actions are common in conventional farming. Let's say these are daily activities. Soil loosening is done multiple times over the year. In other words, we use a lot of fuel to get our soil prepared for the season. In these tillage modes, we are able to set our depth range, as well as we can choose where we would like to penetrate deeper in the soil. These algorithms working the best on soils which were already pre-treated with our contour profiling or plow pan remover modes. Our special soil treatment programs, contour profiling and plow pan removing, were designed to search for anomalies in the topsoil mapper's full penetration depth. Therefore, in these modes, depth range settings is unavailable. These algorithms are working in most of the world, with heavy machinery in deeper regions of the soil. In this case, we sacrifice fuel savings on getting the most optimized depth treatment of our soil. It is important to highlight here that all the variable depth tillage program can be used online, means topsoil mapper is attached to the tractor and controls on the fly the tillage, as well as offline, as the map-based mode, where we calculate tillage parameters based on earlier scans. Setting up the online scene and the prescription map is having exactly the same procedure and function. Let's see the first cultivation mode in details. Shallow cultivation algorithm was designed to use on soils with higher bug density. The sensor first and part of the second receiver coil takes responsibility on controlling the cultivator on the back. The ideal working depth, based on user preferences, can be set between 1 and 25 cm. The default vertical tillage direction guides the automatic tillage control kit by lower conductivity in case of lighter soils, deeper tillage values, while in areas with higher conductivity by denser soil, ATC gets shallower values. The settings can be inverted, whereby higher EC we are going to dig deeper. As I mentioned before, by general soil treatment we kept an eye on resource preservation, therefore the use of default setting is highly advised. Subsoiling, as the other soil treatment, advised to use on lighter soils in an applicable depth of 25-50 cm. This algorithm is using the second and part of the third coil in depth evaluation. By this strategy, exactly the same parameters and details can be set as by the shallow cultivation. The only difference is that it operates in a deeper region. Moving the demonstration to the special soil treatments, our first delinquent is the contour profiling algorithm. Here I would like to highlight the significant differences between the general and the special treatments. From agronomical perspective, it is important that these algorithms are not for yearly use. From the technical side, I have to cover the following bullet points. First, special soil treatments are fully automated and are using the full range, let's say the full penetration depth of the sensor. Why? Since the contour must be found by the sensor automatically. In this context, plow pan is also a contour line. The other main technical difference is that the user is unable to set the depth range, neither to invert the tillage strategy. The base for all calculations are the depth interface values, where we can set a constant minus offset from our contour line. This will result that the tillage equipment will follow shallower the contour line in the soil. I can come up with a really good example from the United Kingdom. Close to the shores, soils are having a really shallow clay topsoil layer, but it is not also uncommon that after 30 cm a silty pebbly subsoil comes immediately, without any transition. Of course, we don't want to mix up this layer with the topsoil. So here, a contour profiling capable cultivator is a top-notch in our asset. The last tillage strategy is the plow pan removal algorithm. This works exactly the same way like the contour profiling. As I mentioned already, plow pan is also a contour on a certain way in our soil. Therefore, the algorithm can follow it with a certain plus offset in order to tear it up. Since not every year we are able to build up a new plow pan layer, we should not use this activity every year. We can verify with other topsoil mapper scannings during the year if depth to interface values are coming closer to the surface or a range where homogeneity is a must. And therefore, accordingly, we can schedule a plow pan removal tillage if it needed. I hope you enjoyed watching this small tutorial. Please follow us on social media channels, and I hope to see you next time too. Bye bye!